All of our perceptions occur through our brain, right? All of our memories are stored in our brain. And when we have an experience, neurons are firing. So if I was to recall that experience, one would assume similar neurons are firing, right? We have to have structures in the brain that facilitate memory. Hippocampus is the main one that we would associate with learning new memories, especially of the explicit type. Can't have any new memories without a hippocampus, apparently, right? But it's a powerful structure that facilitates learning. We talked about the amygdala a little bit when we were talking about one trial learning, right? A really powerful emotional experience. Well, emotions seem to be mediated through areas of the brain we call the limbic system, right, which includes the amygdala, and it seems to be really implicated in having that one trial learning experience with a really powerful emotion associated with the experience. Tends to be easier to remember later. If it's a really negative experience, pain, fear, or sickness, it might only take one trial to make a learning event permanent. And it could become so permanent that you don't even remember the source of it if it happened early in childhood. That you could get a phobia or a taste aversion that lasts on into your adulthood and you don't even remember the source of it. You just know that you've never liked that thing. Well, long-term potentiation, when we're looking at trying to explain memory from a biological perspective, we're really kind of trying to get at something that's hard to understand. We can say what's happening, why it's happening is another matter, but what seems to happen is when a neuron's stimulated, we now know about neuroplasticity. We're not going to get a whole bunch of new brain cells, but the brain cells we have last lifetimes, and they can change. Physically, they can grow dendritic structures, they can grow axonal structures, and they can pair them off. They can prune them back. So they're dynamic cells that respond in every moment of our lives to every moment of our lives. Every thought you have, every emotion you have, every deed you do, everything you perceive. And so you have a pattern of neuron firing. The neurons firing, well, if you do the similar thing again, that same pattern would fire. If you do it again, the same pattern would fire. The idea is the more you fire that same pattern or similar patterns, you're going to start getting to a point where it's easy to fire that pattern. And you've experienced this when you learn something for a test. When at first it seems really confusing and you have to figure it out, but then you got it figured out and you do it again and you do it again. And you do it again, and then all you need is really just a prompt, a primer, and you can remember it. The firing becomes a natural, easy process because physically speaking, it's becoming facilitated as you do your learning. Again, with the amygdala, it seems like you can facilitate deep learning very quickly under certain circumstances without much effort. It just happens that way. Seems to have survival value. Consolidation is the evolution of a temporary, not temperature, a temporary neural circuit, meaning the pattern of neurons firing, into a more enduring circuit, one that's easier to fire. And ultimately, when you look at conditioning memory, that implicit memory we talked about, you don't even have to think about it. You just do it. When you drive and start driving for the first time, you get very conscious about all the things you're doing. But the more you do it, the more you fire the similar patterns of neurons, and eventually you can drive somewhere without even realizing you drove there. And you're like, how did I get here? I was talking, listening to music, daydreaming, but driving happened because that set of circuits that is responsible for driving is so well oiled, if you will, that it functions pretty much on its own. And if you need to pay attention, you will pay attention.